Hi again, everyone. This is Jeff of TAOFLEDERMAUS. Today, we're going to look at the 1 ounce BALLISTIC PRODUCTS Thug Slug. These slugs are sold just as you see them, and they're intended for reloaders. These come in 12 gauge, 20 gauge, and also 410. And cost is about $15 for 25 slugs. The plastic wadding is designed to fly along with the lead slug. It all stays together in flight. And that is kind of reminiscent of these Poliva Russian slugs that are about 30 years old. You can see that the lead slug is just held on with friction fit, and somehow that stays together during flight. And the tail of this thing acts like a shuttlecock, creating drag. And right now you're probably saying, hey, that looks a lot like the Brenneke slug. Here's a great video by TN Outdoors 9 if you want to compare the damage between these two slugs. Great video. These slugs were provided to us by a viewer, a longtime viewer in fact, Tommy Rad. And he loaded these according to BALLISTIC PRODUCTS loading data for these slugs. Every once in a while we team up with subscribers and viewers who want to be in the videos, and today our guest shooter is Nick. He's a Marine and he will be doing the shooting today. Our first target is a stack of 2x6s. And yes, this is the same target that TN Outdoors 9 did in his video of the Brenneke slugs. And I will put a link to that video in the description and also at the end of this video. Nick is shooting a Benelli Nova with a rifle choke tube.
That was nice.
Now, if you ever wondered why we don't use high brass very much, it's because the powder used in those typically is very smoky and obscures the footage quite a bit. Now in this camera shot, we can see the slug a lot better. You can see that the slug is oscillating quite a bit. Now this slug is going about 1300 feet per second according to the load data. And despite all its efforts, the slug went through the first board and was stuck in the second board, which was a big surprise. Now it appears that these slugs use a rather soft lead. The Brenneke slugs use a very hard lead and have a lot more penetrating power. Our next target is a 5-gallon steel vessel. It's basically a water hammer trap. It's been completely filled with water and the opening is just taped shut.
Didn't blow it up, but you hit dead center.
Now, I expected this slug to give us a little more hydroshock action, actually splitting this vessel open. But as you can see, it just blew a stream of water out of the top through that tape that was sealing the hole. And really, if the vessel had been sealed up a little tighter, it probably would have split it open with no problem. Now, these slugs are designed to be shot out of both smoothbore and a rifled shotgun. And you can actually see it twisting around through the air. But we also see a little bit of waggling or a little bit of oscillation as it's flying through the air. Next we have a disc of lead. This weighs about 15 pounds and is about 1 inch thick. This was cast out of lead shot from shotgun shells. Now it's not impossible to shoot through this lead plate with a slug. In fact, we've done it before with the steel D duplex slugs. And it's really becoming apparent that the thin and very soft lead used in these Thug slugs has very different properties than steel slugs or even the Brenneke slugs. And of course, the softer lead expands a lot more, breaks apart, and dumps its energy a lot quicker than a harder projectile. We didn't blow through the plate, but we knocked a big chunk of it off the back of it. Our final target, ballistic gel. This is clear ballistics gel, the synthetic stuff, and this was donated to us by William from the Wound Channel. I want to thank him for that. We very rarely get any sponsorship companies coming at us and offering us stuff, so we really very much appreciate when other channels can help us out like this. Each bear is about 3 inches thick And we can get comparative results with an entire block of ballistic gel. We can actually space these apart if we want. Each bear seen here is about 2 inches apart. If one bear becomes more damaged than the others, we can just recast that one bear. It's a lot easier than recasting the entire block. Plus, who doesn't like gummy bears?
You hit him dead on.
We handed our Marine a shotgun he never shot before, didn't give him any practice shots, and he's using just the front bead sight. So we didn't have any issues at all with the accuracy with these slugs. The amount of damage these slugs do is a great contrast to what the Brennekes do, especially in regards to the depth of penetration. But does that make one slug better than the other? It all has to do with its application. The Thug Slugs have a lower velocity, a lower kick, and being made out of a soft lead, have much lower penetration than a Brenneke slug. If you have an application that requires that you have no over penetration, these may be the slugs for you. Now this gel test is perhaps the most telling of how much penetration these have. In the first bear, we see a giant core of ballistic medium that had been pushed out of the back. That big hollow cavity in the nose really punched a hole through it. The second bear, we see a lot of tearing and ripping of the gel. And in the third bear, that's where the slug ended up. It didn't even go through 9 inches of ballistic medium. And you can still see the wadding still attached to the lead, but the lead is fragmented and really mangled up. Very interesting test. Although these resemble the Brenneke slugs, the results were quite different. Be sure to check out TN Outdoors 9's video. It's very entertaining and is a very good comparison with these slugs. Thanks for watching.